Hello dear students, in the maths already first topic we are completed. So now we are going to study the second topic, that is the rational numbers. So rational numbers, in that first we will study the numbers here. What are the numbers, what are the types of the numbers here? Numbers, all the 0 to 9 that we call as the numerals, and all the plus one or more numerals together we call as the numbers here. So then, natural number. What is the natural number here? So from the 5th standard onwards, you are studying about the natural number, whole number, integers, rational numbers. Okay. So here, natural number. We know that one. All the counting numbers except 0, that all numbers we call as the natural numbers. Means except 0 means 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. So numbers are not defined, uncountable numbers are there. So but 0 we will not count in the natural numbers. These numbers we call as the natural numbers here. So then after that we become a whole number. What are the whole numbers? So here whole numbers are the natural numbers with 0. So the natural numbers with 0 means it will be includes the 0 also here. So only natural numbers are starting from 1 onwards, but the whole numbers will be includes 0, including natural numbers, all numbers we call as the whole numbers here. 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. These we call as the whole numbers here. So after that, integers. Already in the 7th standard, special topic is there on the integer here. So what are the integers? All the positive, negative numbers we call as the integer. For example, so on, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. These are means 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 0, or we can write like this, 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2. So these are the integers here. Okay, so why these numbers all we need? So here for example, to solving any one equation, we need the all numbers here. Not only the natural numbers we can use and solve the equation, not possible. By taking the whole numbers, then we can solve the equation, means that is also not possible. So by taking the integers, then also we can find the solution of the equation, that is also not possible. For example, here consider x plus 4 is equal to 11. Okay, x plus 4 is equal to 11. So if you want to find the value of x here, so if you want to follow the find the value of x, x is equal to 11 minus 4, take LHS side, equal to sign that side. So then x is equal to, it will be gives us a 7 here. So x value came as a 7. So whether 7 is a whole number or natural number, the question is, yes, 7 is both whole number also, natural number also. So in this case we can use whole number or natural number or integer. 7 is integer also. But some example, if consider x plus 5 is equal to 5. X plus 5 is equal to 5. So what is the value of x here? X is equal to 5 minus 5. X is equal to 0. So when we will fill the 0 in the place of x, then only we can solve the equation here. So then what about, what is 0 here? 0 is a natural number? No. 0 is a whole number, or 0 is also integer. So to solving any one equation, we need all the numbers here. Not only by taking a natural number we want to solve equation, that is also not possible. By taking whole number, that is also not possible. By taking an integer, that is also not possible. We require all the natural number, all the numbers here, whole natural number, whole number, integer, and rational numbers. So then what about these rational number here? So rational numbers are the numbers. These are also numbers, but they are in the form of p by q here. They are in the form of p by q, that numbers we call as a rational number. But the condition here, p and q are integers. P and q must be integers and q does not equal to 0. Numerator does not be 0. If any term has a numerator denominator as a 0, means that term will get the infinite, means non-defined term you will get. So that's why numerator it may be 0, okay, but the denominator never be 0 here. Getting? So p and q must be integers and q does not equal to 0. For example, for the integers here, sorry, rational numbers here, 5 by 3, 1 by 4, 6 by 3. So just 1, 2, whether 1, 2, these are the rational numbers? Yes, these are also rational numbers, because nothing is there, means in the denominator they have 1 here. Yes or no? So means these all numbers we call as a rational number. It may be positive, negative, any. So because you can take negative values also. Minus 3 by 2, minus 5 by 1, So yes, these all are called as the rational numbers. Got now? What are the numbers? Which type of the numbers are there? And where we will use all the numbers? And whether all the numbers are useful or not? So and today we will learn the new, that is the new type of numbers, that is the rational numbers. The numbers which are in the form of p by q, that we call as rational numbers. But the p and q must be are integers, and q does not equal to zero. So now depending on these numbers, some properties are there. Already you know. Closure property, associative property, commutative property. So these property we are going to study now here. Okay, now properties of rational numbers. So why the only properties of rational numbers? Because natural number, whole number, integer. Rational number includes all the numbers. That's why properties of rational number we will study. So in that first one is a closure property. So already in the second standard we studied about this. Closure property. In that first we will study for whole number. So whole number, the closure property will be satisfies or not here. So then addition. Addition. So take an example. 2 is also what? Whole number, and 3 is also whole number. 3 plus 2 plus 3, that is 5. So here 5 is also whole number. Means what will be happen? The whole number addition is closure property will be satisfy addition on whole number. Yes or no? Here the closure property will be satisfy addition on whole number here. Okay, so then we can write in general. So in general, what we can take? So any, if you are taking example as a 2 plus 3 as a 5 here, if so for that number you can take as a plus b is a whole number. A plus b is a whole number. Number for any whole number A and B here. So any whole number A and B. A plus B is a whole number any whole number for any two whole numbers A and B. So if A and B, any two whole number, A plus B is also whole number. Means when we will take A plus B is whole number only. A plus B here, A is 2, B is 3. So that is an example here. So A is also whole number, B means here 3 is also whole number. Sum of these two whole number is whole number only, means A plus B is whole number for any two whole numbers here. A plus B is whole number for any two whole numbers. You can take 10 plus 5, that is 15, that is also whole number. 20 plus 5, 25, that is also whole number. Yes or no? So means the closure property for whole number under addition will be satisfies here. So therefore we can write here. So what we have to write the conclusion, that whole numbers are under closure property. Sorry, whole numbers on the closure property will be satisfied. Otherwise, whole numbers are closed under the addition. Whole numbers are closed under the addition. Right, you can write like this. Closure property will be satisfied for addition on whole numbers. That is also you can write here. So second one will become addition, after will become subtraction. So next one will become subtraction. Okay, so then here subtraction we need here. 5 minus 2, it will be gives 3 here. So this is one example. So you can take 5 minus 7, that will be gives us minus 2. So this will be satisfied, but whether this will be satisfied? So any for negative answers here? So no, na? So therefore we can write here what we have to write. So there is whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. Only this much. Only we have to write instead of not closed under subtraction. So what will happen? So a minus b is not a whole number when for any a and b. Some a and b are not for any a and b. So therefore, whole numbers. So what are not closed? This is important. Not closed under subtraction. Not closed under subtraction means that will be not satisfied. Closure property will be not satisfied for the whole numbers under subtraction here. So because here negative is not a whole number here. Minus 2 is not a whole number here. So but here for any negative numbers you can take it will become a whole. Only we are studying whole numbers here. And minus 2 is not a whole number here. So next one, third one, that is multiplication. So take a example, any two examples you can take. So here 0 into 3, that is 0. 3 into 7, that is 21. So 0 is also whole number, 21 also whole number here. So means what we have, we can write here, the whole number will be satisfied. Otherwise, close under the multiplication, whole numbers will be closed under the multiplication. Or we can write the in general. So in general, A into B is whole number. A into B is whole number for any two whole number. Any two whole number A and B. And finally, therefore, whole numbers are closed under multiplication. So this is what multiplication on the closure property. So next one will become, what will become? Division. Next one will become division. So this is a fourth one. Division is fourth one. So here consider example 5 by 8. So here take a, before that 5 divides 8. So 5 divides 8. 5 divided by 8. So 5 divided by 8 is whole number? No, that is a rational number. So that's why here what 5 divided by 8 is not a whole number. So in 5, when we divide a 5 by 8, we will not get a whole number here. So therefore we can write here, therefore whole numbers are not satisfies closure property on division you can write, otherwise closure under division you can, are not closed under division. So got na? So here means what? Only addition and multiplication. Only what will be satisfies closure property on the whole number here. Closure under the whole number, which are those? Addition and multiplication. So closure property on whole number we are studied here. Now we will going to study for the closure property on the integers.